Hey, so excited. Another one I pre-ordered a few months ago, Barbie 55th Anniversary Christie doll, and she arrived actually earlier this week, and I'm so happy I can give you a closer look at her, and we are going to take her out of box because I got two, because I knew that I was going to want to, because that face is supposed to be awesome. All right, time to get into it. So exciting! Oh my goodness, can you see how pretty that face is? Like, oh my goodness. Wow, wow, wow. Love her. Let's get a closer look. Oh my goodness. So cool. And then here is the back of the box. Let me make sure it's focusing. Okay. And then this is the one that she is designed for. So honoring the original one, we have an updated version. And she is so pretty. Oh, all right, time to get her out of the box. Oh, my goodness, so pretty. All right. Okay, so let's show before I get her completely out of the box. There you go. So pretty. All right. All right, I'm gonna have to take her, like, do this in my lap. I feel better about doing that. Alright, so I just wanted to show you everything she came with. She came with the certificate of authenticity. Sorry, I'll turn that the right side. Since I have two, I was just gonna, you know, leave it in the box. Don't need that for me, for this one. And then she also came with the Model Muse type stand, but this is a curvy Model Muse, so maybe the stand's a little bit different. I'm not the biggest fan of the Model Muses. And thank you, Bill Greening. When he was posting about this on his Instagram page, I thought she was new, curvy size, and he said, nope, nope, we've used this body type before. It's just been not as commonly used, and thank you, because I was unaware. This is my first curvy Model Muse doll that I've gotten, and she is wearing a hairnet. I think it was a hair, yep. Oh, it's caught on the necklace. Her hair is very soft and actually it reminds me a lot of my Mini-Me's hair texture, but it is different. Like, the curl texture is a little bit different, and I do have my Mini-Me handy. So she's a bit worn, but her curls are a little bigger. So this is obviously like the finer curl, but it is like she needs some hair help. She was just at the doll show. But it is very soft, and she does have like a little snag here out of the elastic that pulls her hair back. She has the curvy, as I said before, and so she's a little thicker in the hips and the bust. But I don't know that much about them because she is my first one, and I do plan on rebodying her, and we'll get into that, but first I just want to kind of go over some of her details. I love her orange shoe boot style. Not sure on the shoe size if it's the same as curvies and talls. That would be a really nice, but I love this style. Like, I love this design of this shoe. Have we seen this before? Because I know there's a lot out there and I have definitely not seen it all, but I am not familiar with this, and I love it. I'm also really digging her sheer over skirt dress. And then she does have a buckle here, a belt. And it is one that is not in the back, so you actually have to undo it in the front here. And I believe, yeah, there's a little plastic jibber right here holding everything together, so I'm pretty sure that this stuff's all separate. I'm not gonna get her undressed right this second, but yeah, like that face. I think she's one of the looks dolls faces. It's dated on the back of her head 2021. But yeah, so she's got the little short dress that's in orange, has some plastic straps. She's got a gold C monogram necklace. She has the overdress that's floor length or a little more, and the gold belt that matches the cuffs, and she's got the gold earrings. And I'm thinking I might have a close match for her for a made to move. Now, it's a standard body type, and I would love to get some more options in some of the more standard tones. But yeah, I actually have one out of box already. She's the Fashionista. Oh my goodness, I don't remember what number. But she's the one in the wheelchair, the one that was right before this newest wave of wheelchair Fashionistas. But she's the one in the rainbow striped dress. So, let's see. Pretty close. Let me check in the sun. I have a natural light just off to the side here. Yeah, so it is pretty good of a match. I always like to check my matches in natural sunlight, just to try to get the best possible match. So yeah, the wheelchair Fashionista in the rainbow dress Fashionista in the wheelchair. She's gonna be probably the closest match that I know of. But yeah. Wow. She is just so pretty though. I love her face and her outfit. I love when I'm able to dress my girls in, my darker skin girls in some of these bright colors. I just think they look so good in those bright colors. And it's one of the colors I like to dress. Maybe that's why I liked hers, because it was like, just spoke to me. She looked so good. But yeah, so I am going to do the head swap and I will come back with final results for you in a couple of minutes, because I don't have water right now in my studio here where I film and stuff. I should at some point in the future, but yeah, the sink's not working right now. Be back! Okay, so I got her head on to the Made to Move, and it's very close, so it's a decent match. There is just the slightest bit of difference, but it's not too bad. And I started, like, taking off the clothes because I was going to put them on her, so let me continue doing that. And we've got the belt. It is just pretty much basic little belt. And then there was like a little plastic jibber holding this closed. So you have that. So here she is in just the orange. Or at least the body. And those sleeves are very tight at the cuffs for these hands. We'll see how they go when I put it on her. Alright, so we've got the body. And I'm gonna see now about how her outfit fits on the Made to Move, because there are some differences in size, but it should fit pretty good. Fits pretty good, pretty snug, so like, it's not, it's actually fits, it's not like the regular model muse clothes that are usually like, you gotta stretch it. This fits like really nice and like perfect. So I'm gonna check out her shoes now. They seem to fit pretty well, so that's good. I wasn't sure how they were gonna fit. There is like a little bit of like extra room in there at the leg, but it's actually overall is not a bad fit whatsoever. Really digging the orange here. Let's give her a necklace. So she's looking pretty good. Has all the Made to Move joints now. 22 points of articulation. Love it. Alright, I'm gonna put this back on and see how easy, hard, you know, it can be. Alright, so I got that on. It is pretty tight. You just want to make sure that you're just careful with the fingers. I expect it'll probably be a little easier to get off. She doesn't have such a wide hand, but you just do want to be careful. So if you have like those plastic corners that some people use to feed through like sweaters and different clothing pieces, that would be a really good idea. I don't have any handy right this second, or, well, I don't have any handy right now, and I'm gonna put her belt back on and we can see how she looks made to move. Alright, here she is. She's all made to move, and in her outfit. Now, I did have some issue with the belt. Her curvy self, that curvy Model Muse body still has a skinnier waist by a little bit, because, like, I am barely able to actually push that belt in there, and it's pretty tight, and, I even stretched it maybe a little. But yeah, so she's in there, the shoes fit, the outfit looks really awesome on her, and I love that she has articulation now. I probably will end up putting a different belt on her, just because I'm not, like, the biggest fan of how short this is, but I don't really have a lot of gold, like, belts and stuff. I've been trying to get some more, stuff like that. Socks and belts. And I've made some, but I haven't been able to make, you know, some of it. But yeah, really, really love the pieces, the fashion pieces. I'm hoping the orange mini dress will last for quite some time. I don't have the greatest luck with pleather material, just because I live somewhere humid and, like, time, like, even climate controlled, like, it's still not great where I live, and it tends to get worn a bit. But I love the overdress. This layer is really great, and I love her boots, shoes. Yeah, really, really love her. Recommend, if you're able to get her, do. I really love her. Great tribute, and she'll definitely probably stay in her orange boots and outfit for a while, just because I'm really, really digging her in her outfit. And I'm definitely going to be posting some pictures on Instagram, so definitely going to have to check those pictures out. But yeah, like and subscribe. Thank you for your time. Bye.